that tweet. He wrote, they tweeted again, why is Jewish-owned press so consistently anti-Israel in every crisis? And it set off a little bit of a firestorm. What happened? What was the reaction?
The reaction was that people said this was outrageous. I found it stunningly offensive, Soledad. First of all, Jewish-owned press, the old anti-Semitic stereotype about Jews controlling the media, and then saying anti-Israel, Merrick's very pro-Israel. And somebody needs to keep this guy away from the Twitter.
He loves it, though, right? He's always on Twitter.
He does, and so are a lot of other powerful people, CEOs. And I think what they don't realize is that they have a very large audience here. And they don't have a PR person, a PR flack, saying, you really probably shouldn't say that. They're tweeting in their beds at night or, you know, in their studies all by themselves and sending off these missives that otherwise would have been more carefully crafted.
Nobody says no to these people. And Soledad, it took Murdoch 2 days to apologize, which took the form of a letter to
tweet. Well, he tweeted, right? An apology?
I wouldn't even consider that an apology because it wasn't clear what
kind
he was saying.
Kind of a non-apology apology. Here's what he tweeted. Jewish-owned press, in quotes now, have been sternly criticized, suggesting link to Jewish reporters. Don't see this, but apologize unreservedly.
Okay, what does that mean? I didn't even understand the first part of the sentence.
I think it means someone has told me to apologize. Yeah. So here's my apology.
So here's my non-apology.
There's no explanation for the beginning part where he talks about the Jewish-owned media. Because as you said, that's like, you know, come on, give us something that's not 100 years or thousands of years old and just flat wrong. But just to sort of lay out the elephant in the room and talk about it, I think part of the second part talking about anti-Israel is that is where his corporation, and specifically talking about the television network, Fox, tries to position itself as a place where people who are pro-Israel go.
But that's the problem, then, is that...
I'm not defending it.
No. But when Murdoch spouts off, and these are his personal views, and he's 81, and he's the corporate chief, and no one's going to tell him not to, it does reflect badly, I think, on Fox News. And in addition to that, the reason that semi-apology didn't work is that he then had to write a letter to the Anti-Defamation League to do the full grovel, because there was enough heat to make Murdoch realize that he had to walk it back.
He tweeted this, too. Let me read this one, then I'll let you do it. Can't Obama stop his friends in Egypt shelling Israel?
I mean, don't you think this is all part of the marketing, though, of Fox and part of, you know, how they get attention? And, I mean, you guys follow this. This is your business. I mean, it seems to me that this is part of Fox marketing.
No, I think this is part of your kind of crazy uncle firing off.
See,
on
I think
Twitter.
That that's what they want you to think, but I don't think that's what it is.
I think it's
very deliberate.
More Machiavellian.
Yes, I do.
I've talked to people who work in that media empire, and some of them were just cringing about this. It's like, there he goes again. And also for Rupert Murdoch, who presided over the phone hacking scandal and his London tabloid, to be sort of giving moral instruction about how the pressure behaves is a little bit off.
Petraeus, resignation, timing, everything, suspicious. There has to be more to the story. I don't follow him, but I'm going to start. Because honestly, I think it's awesome.
So as soon as you said that, I thought to myself, we're going to get this guy so many more followers.
I know. This reminds me of Jack Welch, who tweeted,
exactly,
you know, that the
right.
Chicago gang, meaning Obama's team, was cooking mm-hmm. the unemployment numbers. I mean, these guys just get
or
on there.
Trump, who said that the election was a sham and a travesty.
March on Washington. That was my favorite one, when he called for the March on Washington, Donald Trump.
Yeah.
Yeah, awesome.
He's going to lead it. Orange hair billionaires for change.
First it was Martin Luther King's March on Washington. All these years later, Donald Trump.